So just about set. And on the mound today, Joe Boyle.
Well, this guy's just been filthy out there on the mound. Hitters batting under 200 against him, and they're just having a hard time squaring up anything, doing any type of damage. The only way he hurts himself is if he gives up the free passes and surrenders a rare home run. But outside of that, it's going to be a tough job for the opposing lineup today.
Popped up to the left into foul ground. Hernandez hauls it in, and there's one away.
Let's take a look at the Brewers lineup. And Chris, this group has been struggling to put up runs lately. Well, they haven't been on base a ton, and even when they are, they haven't been hitting very well with the runners on base. So they need a player or two to really step up, have some quality at-bats, hit according to the situation, and sort of break out of this. I think if they do, the rest of this lineup will follow.
One out, base is empty. In the air, left side. And that'll fall for a base hit. And now it's William Contreras. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
This might be a steal situation, but that's not your average catcher.
Runner on the go. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Hernandez drifts towards it. Feeling for the wall. Makes the catch in foul ground.
Got the pitch that he wanted. Just a little bit quick. Front shoulder open. Backside collapsed a little bit. And the launch angle, not where he needed it to be.
Willie Adames in the box now. No balls and a strike. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. He sends it out of here. His 23rd of the year, and they jump out front. He absolutely feasts on right-handed pitching and devours that one for a homer.
And you can see that's what he expects of himself. At bat after at bat, he's that confident.
And first offering is fouled off. Two outs, base is empty. And a pitch. Just missing there. Ball one.
That one called just inside, I think, and on the mound. Trying to get a little bit of an explanation. Doesn't seem to be too bothered by it, though, but he clearly thought it clipped the corner.
And that'll do it. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 2-0 ball game. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here with my pal Ziggy, getting the nod on the mound, Aaron Civale. And Chris, pitching on the road has not been particularly kind to him.
Yeah, and you don't want to be too quick to say that you can't pitch on the road. Sometimes, you know, it's just a matter of luck. It's not having a feel. Difference between the bullpen mound to the mound out there on the playing field. Don't know what it is, but I know this. He's got good enough stuff to overcome and get it done on the road as well as at home. So we'll see what he's able to do with this one.
And that's just foul.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Right side, hard hit. Fires over to Hoskins. One gone, bottom half of the first. And time now to check out the A's lineup. Not a team that usually sees a lot of pitches or works a ton of walks, Chris. They take a more aggressive approach than some of the other teams in the league.
They definitely have a few free swingers in this lineup, hitters who want to be on the attack, and that's great as long as you got pitches in the zone. But if the pitcher's able to expand the zone, it can be very difficult for an offense like this to get going. You've got to somehow draw some walks, put some runners on base, so that when you do have those free swingers come up, you can cash in with some runs that are played.
Swung on, belted. That's back there.
This team will not quit. It's like you said, the ball up there. That's typically actually not the easiest way to hit a home run. The slight opposite field into the gap. Man, making it look easy, that's for sure.
One out, base is empty. This is J.J. Blade. High fly ball, right field. He's got it.
Well, there's two away.
Here's Miguel at Duhar. That one ripped. And foul ball. Two down, nobody on. Hammered. And this one could be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second.
That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front, hit into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel it.
Oh, now this one's high and deep.
Way back there. On its way. Gone.
He powers that one out of here. It's their second home run of the inning, and they take the lead. It's 3-2. Listen to these fans.
This place is absolutely buzzing right now. You can hear the energy all the way up here in our broadcast booth.
So two down. Seth Brown will hit next. On the ground right side. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. But two round trippers in this inning. The long ball was working. It's now a 3-2 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. And it's Rhys Hoskins up to the dish. His July and August splits there. Pitch misses inside, and that's ball one.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. Just hope that he can get through this inning and bats back up there while they're hot.
Tosses to first. One up, one down. Joseph Ortiz up now for the Brewers. His home and away splits there. And there's a strike. Good heater at 98.
He gave up a couple of runs in the first. His offense picked him up. It's time for him to settle in now and throw up some zeros on that scoreboard.
And a pop-up. Right side, foul territory. Nice grab on the run. Two down. So digging in, Andrew Monasterio. This one in the air. Gets under it. Brings it in. And that is that. Nobody left for Milwaukee. They're down 3-2. Back now with a new arm on the mound to start the bottom of the second. Tobias Myers.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
A line of kick pitch. And that one hammered. That skips over the fence, so it's an automatic double. So, man aboard, Darryl Hernandez, up next for the A's.
Watch me.
Bounced up the middle. Oh, great stop. Throws from his knees. It's there, and that's a great play.
Look at the commitment to make the play. Down on the ground from the knees. That's not just arm strength, guys. That's core strength as well. Look at that rocket across the diamond. Outstanding job.
Swing, and that's ripped towards right center. Perkins brings it in with a nice running grab. Throw behind the runner, they got him doubled off. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. We played two full. It's the A's 3 and the Brewers 2. On to the third inning. And now the right fielder, Sal Freeland. Here comes a pitch. And a swing and a miss there.
Boom, that's cheddar, baby.
Fought off foul.
Got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. I really think the outer half is open.
Popped up to the left. Into foul ground. And there's one down. turns over. Jackson Chourio now at the plate. And that one fouled off.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two.
Really going after him here. All fastballs to get ahead of the count.
Yes, it misses. It's a strikeout.
Man, there was no deviating from the fastball right there. He just kept coming after him with it. Here it is. Hit it if you can. And he just couldn't find a way to put it in play.
Perkins batting for the second time. And that's strike one. And that's off the inside edge. And the count even 1-1. Looking to get the tying run on base. Swing and a pop up. Settles underneath it. And that'll do it. The A's hold on to win a 2-1 as this one ends as a 1-1 ball game.
Well, 3-inning games are pretty exciting, and this one did not disappoint. Tons of offense, but it came down to just one run. This was a wild one.
3-2, the final score. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.